Captain's log, Stardate 2623.3. Urgent cryptic orders have mysteriously diverted the Enterprise to Space Station K7 and the disputed area with the Klingon Empire.
Jim, what's going on?
Bones, you know as much as we do. I can tell you this much. We're not the only starship that's involved.
We've monitored coded orders to 29 starships and 12 Starfleet installations.
This sector's become extremely unstable since the disappearance of the Organians.
The Klingons have become increasingly active after realizing enforcement of the treaty is now problematic.
Gentlemen, let's get some answers.
Well, I don't like it. This cloak and dagger stuff always manages to fill my sick bay.
Let's get some answers, gentlemen. Mr. Scott, energize.
Admiral Sheen, welcome aboard.
Jim, good to see you.
See you. You know my officers, Dr. McCoy, Mr. Spock, Commander Scott.
Scotty.
This is Commodore Probert, Captain Martin.
What's this all about, sir?
Well, the Klingons are about to destroy every vestige of peace we have with them.
Well, there haven't been any reports of raiding or pirating in the system for quite some time.
Well, they've been pulling back, gathering an attack force. Klingon battle groups are massing around every planet and station on the border.
War games are not uncommon training tactics.
No. This is much bigger than anything we've ever seen. Now, a massive attack on the Federation is imminent.
Admiral, I have great respect for Starfleet intelligence, but trying to interpret Klingon mentality...
Captain, it's confirmed. Epsilon 9 has intercepted and authenticated a battle plan that'll turn your blood cold.
Our orders, sir.
To proceed directly to the Klingon homeworld. And once there, convince the Emperor to give up this plan of war.
To Kronos? With one starship? You're talking suicide.
We'll be facing the entire Klingon fleet before we get a parsec in their space.
You'll have an advantage. Mr. Scott, beam over our guest.
What guest?
Your best shot at arriving on Kronos safely. He'll give you all the details you need in order to secure a safe mission. Remember when the Organians said that we would end up working together despite our many differences? Well, the two of you are going to have to do just that. You have to stop this war before it begins.
Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Enterprise. Its five-year mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before. Log, supplemental. With war looming, the Enterprise has been ordered deep into Klingon territory. To the Klingon homeworld. Our mission, to convince their Emperor to stand down. Our guide, a Klingon warrior who shows no signs of having been affected by the augment virus.
None of you Earthers ever seen a Klingon?
Only those genetically engineered.
Improved. With human DNA.
Stop!
This is Captain James T. Kirk. He's the commander of this ship. Captain, this is Kishaw.
He escaped the Empire in a freighter, Jim. We picked him up on Sherman's planet.
Kishaw was tutor to the Emperor. He's working with us, Jim.
No Klingon would ever defect, and I sure as hell wouldn't trust him if he did.
I've not defected, nor am I working with you. We merely have a mutual goal.
We've been able to verify most of his information, and he's convinced Starfleet that this mission can succeed.
If we can reach the Kitumba, this war can be averted, Captain.
What's a Kitumba?
Not a what, Doctor. A whom?
The Kitumba is their emperor. He's a sacred ruler who rules as a god.
He carries the blood of Kalis. All of the planets, peoples, and battle fleets of the Empire are his personal property.
Civilized people do not own other people.
The history of your Earth says otherwise.
A loyal slave. And yet you come here ready to sell out your emperor. Why?
The Kitumba is a 16-year-old boy. Since birth, he's been sheltered. He's never left Kronos. He's scarcely more than a figurehead.
The real power lies with his regents, Warlord Malkathon and his deputy, Kali.
For 5 years, Malkathon has been gathering forces loyal to himself, amassing power which is not rightfully his.
And you're telling me that the Kitumba is going to ignore his most trusted regent and advisor and listen to his dismissed, and I assume disgraced, tutor.
As regent, Malkathon declared the boy's education ended in order to get rid of Kashaw. Now, it's my gut feeling that the Kitumba knew the reality of what they face. He would never endorse the war that Malkathon is planning.
The more I hear of this, the less I like it. A Klingon that would betray his own people because he's afraid of war? I just don't buy this.
I do not fear war, Captain. I relish it.
Really? Then why don't you tell me what a Klingon warrior is really afraid of?
A dishonorable death. This is not war, Captain. This is certain death with no purpose. As formidable as the forces at Mount Thun has gathered, the Federations are no less so. I know the power of your starships. I fought them in my younger days. Only mutual annihilation can come from open war between us.
If the Kitumba comes of age in the midst of such a war, Klingon pride will demand that he continue it.
And Mount Thun will remain in control? There'll be no avoiding it.
Bones, take Mr. Kishaw down to sickbay for an examination.
You question my honor, Captain? So be it. Subject me to all your truth devices. You will find I do not lie. The Empire prepares a massive strike from many directions with all our forces.
Look, we're going to a war zone. Would you rather I figure out your biology while I'm tending to your injuries?
A warrior would not need the interference of an Earth doctor.
A tutor or peace emissary might.
Jack. You realize you're risking my ship and the lives of my crew on the chance that this Klingon is trustworthy.
Kishaw can help you avoid patrols and open battles.
Or he could lead us into both.
Capturing the Enterprise would allow the Klingons to dissect its technology.
And destroy the balance of power!
Which is precisely why the Klingons should never, ever get the Enterprise. Are we clear, Captain?
Perfectly. We're expendable.
Groups in Sector 12, 14, and 19 are in place and prepared. All colonies on the border are manned and ready for battle, Lord Malkathon.
Good. Now we position our fleets to fill the void between. Our ships will be so numerous they'll blot out the very stars.
Captain Nitok informs us of a glorious victory, Lord. A fleet of merchant vessels destroyed on the way to Sherman's planet.
Personal ambition. Kill him.
He's just a boy, Malkathon, with no powers, no contacts, and knows nothing.
Yet we waste 100 ships guarding his sacred presence. There is no place in my plan for a weak, pampered boy.
Report. En route to the Klingon border, sir. Steady as she goes, the bridge is yours.
We've never ventured this far into a disputed area without encountering Klingon ships.
Well, with Kishaw's help, hopefully we won't encounter any more. You all know our mission. And if we're to have any chance of success, it's going to depend on this crew's ability to work with our guests.
You know, I got to hand it to him, Jim. Kishaw doesn't trust us any more than we trust him, but... I'll be damned if he didn't sit still for every test I could think of.
I'm finding Kishaw to be more reasonable than any Klingon we've encountered, and much less governed by emotion than humans. Quite unexpected. And refreshing.
Well, Spock, if you prefer Klingons, I'm sure we can arrange to leave you behind.
Environmental.
We've adjusted Kishaw's quarters to meet his specifications, and I got Botany digging up all the live worms they can spare.
Captain Kirk, I have information which will ensure we reach Kronos in safety.
We have charts mapped during a mission of Enterprise in X-01.
President Archer's mission was over 100 years ago. I offer updated charts and vital information on military posts and patrol schedules.
That's rather odd information for a teacher to have.
Not for the teacher of the Kitumba.
Lieutenant Uhura, send this down to Astrometrics.
Aye, sir.
Captain, sensors have registered a man-made object for an instant.
Again, for 2.3 seconds.
Location?
253 Mark 4.
Unable to determine range.
Lieutenant, put it on the main viewer. Extreme mag.
Captain, it is a ghost ship and must be destroyed.
We've heard rumors of fast one-man ships with cloaking devices.
I will not reveal the defenses of the Empire, not even to complete this mission.
You might have mentioned that before we sailed into Klingon space.
Ghost ships are unarmed, Captain. All power is reserved for the cloaking device.
Then it's not much of a threat.
Untrue, Captain. We are in disputed space, headed directly for the Empire's border. If he gains the power to transmit our position, he will notify the fleet of our intentions. You cannot find him, Captain. Allow me to assist.
Jim, is this our mission? To destroy every ship we meet? We'll be no better than the Klingons.
We'd be replacing warfare with terrorism.
Another contact, sir. 2 seconds.
Captain, our mission ends here if he transmits our position.
Jim, you're hunting an unarmed ship.
Its subspace radio is its weapon, Doctor.
Assist, Mr. Spock.
Plotting its course. Feeding to navigation.
Follow that ship. Lay in a course, warp factor 6.
Aye, sir.
I have it. Approximately 200,000 kilometers.
Mr. Chekhov, I need photon torpedoes. Timed fuses, 25,000 kilometers.
Torpedoes loaded, Captain.
Tactical on view.
Range, 100,000. Closing fast.
We're going to overshoot him.
Slow to impulse.
He's turned again.
He's got to know he can't escape.
Ship to ship. Broadcast an appeal to surrender.
Surrender, Captain? No Klingon would dishonor himself so. Once he decloaks, he will gain the power to transmit our position.
No response, sir.
50,000.
He will signal it is his duty.
30,000.
Photon torpedoes, broadest possible spread.
At this range, the blast will impact us as well.
Jim, this is murder. Any way you cut it.
Fire.
Mr. Pasal, take damage control reports. Resume course.
Aye, sir.
He died with honor. His name will be remembered by his house.
I've never met a Klingon I'd consider honorable.
You have not met all Klingons, Doctor. Many of our great houses use the concept of honor as their guide.
Doesn't matter what fancy excuse you give it. You didn't even flinch at that man's death.
A small price to pay for peace, Doctor.
It wasn't small to him.
A Class M planet, slightly larger than Earth.
From Kronos, our sacred planet. We have carried the glory of the Klingon Empire to star systems beyond measure.
By carried, you mean enslaved.
Protected, Captain. Each system we bring into the Empire further guarantees the existence of all.
We managed to do that with mutual trade agreements.
Clumsy and inefficient.
I'm sure your subjects would prefer a little inefficiency to Klingon rule.
They have easy lives. For the few laws imposed, they enjoy the benefits of belonging to the Empire.
We experienced those laws and benefits firsthand on Organia.
Then you know, Captain, it is our warriors who lead difficult lives. For the honor of their duty, they serve aboard ships without any of the luxuries you enjoy aboard the Enterprise. Spacious cabins,
soft beds, recreation areas. We reserve our spaces for combat training areas.
Society cannot thrive if all it does is prepare for combat.
We pass on values and history to our children without the aid of swimming pools and bowling alleys on our warships, Doctor.
Well, I'm surprised you make time for children.
Those retired raise our young to the age of warrior training.
Mothers don't raise their own children?
Practice not uncommon on Earth, in cultures where women were thought unfit to teach their sons to die. Sparta, feudal Japan.
Captain, Keisha's star charts aren't adequate. They're vague. From an astronomy textbook, I guess, not a navigational program.
Can you make it work?
Well, I've overlapped the two maps into the database and have programmed the computer to look for uncharted anomalies. But still, the sensors are going to have to work overtime to make sure we don't fly into anything.
Captain to the bridge.
Kirk here.
A Klingon battle group, dead ahead.
Five ships, Captain. Older models, but their weapons are fully armed.
Even the Enterprise isn't a match for five birds of prey.
A massive attack on the Federation is imminent. Proceed directly to the Klingon homeworld. Once there, convince the Emperor to give up this plan of war.
To Kronos? With one starship?
We'll be facing the entire Klingon fleet.
You will not dissuade us from our duty.
This is Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise representing the United Federation of Planets.
I have no stomach for working with the enemy.
Neither do I.
Aim with care!
You can't circumvent them.
Ram this ship down their throats.
A Federation start.
How is this any better than Plan A?
I do not fear war, Captain. I relish it.
This is Walter Koenig. Welcome to Star Trek, New Voyages, Phase 2, Germany. Watch me in To Serve All My Days, written by D.C. Fontana. All episodes are subtitled in German, English, and other languages. Enjoy the show.